Well, thanks very much, everybody, and a very warm welcome to this concert. Thank you for supporting it. I've enjoyed rehearsing on this newly restored instrument, although you might be forgiven for thinking that there's actually three instruments in front of you, one on the right, one in the middle, and one on the left. Let me show you. Here's the one on your right. Here's the one over there on the left. And last, but by no means least, the new section in the middle. And obviously you're going to hear all the sounds of the three sections of this organ in the course of this concert. Well, I'm going back to the 18th century now to a composer called Johann Ernst. He was actually a prince in the Weimar Republic. And sadly, he died at that very tender age of 18 years old. And there's no doubt that if it wasn't for the great J.S. Bach, who transcribed his violin concerto, we would certainly never have heard of him. This is an extremely cheerful piece in three short movements, and in the first two movements in particular, you'll hear the interplay between, as it were, the orchestra and the soloist. You also might be interested to know that in the second slow movement, I shall be using two solo sounds on the organ, the oboe and the clarinet.
Thank you.
Thank you. I've given you some fair indication of the history of the next set of pieces, the four sketches by Robert Schumann. But I'd just like to add that when these pieces are played on the organ, they're quite useful for demonstrating the different sounds of which the organ is capable. So, for example, in the first sketch, I'm going to be using what we might call foundation tones, the sort of sounds produced by the pipes that you see on the front of the organ. In the second, I'm going to use some of the louder trumpet stops. In the third, what we call a full chorus, mixture chorus, the sort of sound Bach would have heard. And then in the fourth and final one, I'm going to use some of the softest stops on the organ. Thank you. Thank you very much. If I was asked what did I think was the most beautiful, short, romantic piece ever written for the organ, I'm pretty sure I would choose this next one, Reger's Benedictus, a prayer in music. And I'm going to use a little device that we organists sometimes use called a tremulant, which causes the wind pressure to supply the pipes to wobble. But don't worry, hopefully in a good way. So it sort of makes it sound a little bit like vibrato. It'll be very obvious in this piece. And this piece really illustrates some of the very beautiful soft sounds on this organ. Thank you. When I was planning this programme quite some time ago, I'd rather forgotten, I'm afraid, about the Queen's Jubilee, so I'm rather pleased that I did include this dedication march by one of my predecessors at Methodist Central Hall, Westminster, William Lloyd Webber. Because this piece really has it all. It's a bit like an Elgar pomp and circumstance piece with a big tune in the middle, which comes back at the end. It's a little more advanced harmonically than Elgar, but I think very much you will get the idea. And you will also hear in this piece, for the first time, this organ's loudest stop, the tuba, which is above my head, thankfully, so I don't hear it too much.
Thank you.
Thank you. The very first organist of Central Hall back in 1912 was Arthur Meal, and he's probably most famous for making quite a number of gramophone records, one in particular entitled Storm, where he would improvise a piece which had a great storm in the middle. It's still often heard today, although it was never actually written down. But he was also somebody who wrote a great deal of rather charming miniatures. He was an extremely popular first organist, apparently, and he organized a series of Saturday night concerts at which he would play the organ, but also he would invite all sorts of other things to take place, including vocal solos, instrumental solos, even, I discovered, a little bit of stand-up comedy, would you believe? I've chosen this piece because I think it represents very well his rather charming orchestral style. the great Alexander Guilmant was organist of La Trinité in Paris and became a very famous man. But he began his career almost self-taught in Boulogne in northern France. And in fact, this piece was written while he was still in Boulogne, and it shows the most incredible promise. I think, as I've written in the notes, Guilmant could make the simplest of melodies sound exciting, and I think this set of variations proves the point.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, once again for supporting this concert. I thought I'd leave you with another piece of Gilmour. Now, I have a theory about this very short little versette. I think that on the way back from La Trinité to his home, Mr. Gilmour probably walked through Montmartre and the rather lascivious Pigalle district of Paris, and perhaps he just caught an earful of some of the music in the theatre at the Moulin Rouge, because I'm certain in this piece I can hear dancing girls.